What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to show you guys how do you install a GFCI with a finished cover. So one of the first things you want to do before you install your GFCI is you want to splice your ground. So as you can see, there's two ground in this box. There's one that's going into the box, which is the ground tail, and then the other one is going straight to the panel. In this job, we use a 12-2 MC. As you can see, I'm splicing all three together. I'm creating a tail to go to the GFCI. Once I finish doing that, I grab my pliers. I cut out the leftovers so it could look nice and neat. And once you finish that, you want to grab your wire nut and you want to make sure it's properly tight. Once you finish doing that, you want to tuck it in into the side of the box. Because as you know, GFCI is a little bit thicker than a regular outlet. So you do that so your box is nicely spliced and nicely done. Once you finish doing that, you want to strip the ground that's going to the GFCI. And then you want to create a hook, a nice hook. But then again, some GFCI, you don't have to do that. You just gotta strip the wire and push it under the screw, under the terminal. So as you can see, I'm using a 20 amp GFCI. This is an outdoor. WR is for weather resistant. I typically love using those type of GFCI in my bathroom, even though it's not required. You could use a regular standard GFCI, but I'd rather put a weather resistant type of GFCI in the bathroom. That's just my preference. So as you can see, I did my ground first, then I did my neutral. If you notice, in the GFCI it has a yellow tape around it. You only use that side. If you had a regular outlet, you could make this GFCI control that outlet on the load side. So once you finish doing all that, the next thing you want to do, you want to grab your electrical tape and wrap it around the outlet just for safety and precaution. So as you can see, it's not hard for the GFCI to go in because I bend the wire in nice in a decent way, so it's easy to go back and forth. As you can see, it's not that hard. So now, as you can see, I'm screwing in my GFCI. You're gonna notice that I'm not gonna screw it all the way in. The reason that is because I'm using a screwless cover in this job. A screwless cover means that the screws behind the cover is nicely flush. You don't see the screw. So this one, you have to pay attention to it because it says top. So the top goes to the top, of course, and then you screw it in. So now, as you can see, once I finish putting my screwless cover, I grab in my level, and then now I'm gonna screw it to make it nicely flush to the sheetrock wall, while holding my level before I put the next cover on top. So once I finish doing that, the next thing I'm gonna do is put the cover in there, and then job done. And remember, you guys, be part of the family, subscribe to the channel as we continue to grow together. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.